Dressed and ready for rehearsal, 12 young women from across BC climb the stairs to the Merritt Civic Center stage. This weekend, they'll all be vying for one of three positions as a BC ambassador, a title that comes not only with a crown, but a responsibility to represent both their hometown and the province as a whole.
Lytton, North Thompson Valley,
Trio,
New Westminster,
Merritt,
Castlegar,
Kamloops,
Oliver,
Kelowna,
Penticton,
Summerland,
Ladysmith.
Jace Van Ruin from Ladysmith says the program is an opportunity for all of the girls to showcase what their community is really about.
Our motto is Heritage by the Sea, and it's an incredible community that focuses on how much our heritage has influenced us through the ages. So to have that, I really wanted to capture that moment and to show everyone how much Ladysmith has to offer because of how much it's grown through these years.
A requirement of the program is the construction of a table display highlighting each represented region. For all of our resident Juliana Martine, participating in the program has shown her just what her region has to offer.
The program helps you get a sense of pride in your town. I know a lot of girls and guys, they have a sort of a resent for their town because they're kind of stuck in it, especially if it's a small town. So learning a bit more about it, I've gotten some more pride in some of the events and some of our historical aspects that they're really amazing, actually.
I made sure to include the wine glass.
Alexandra Burnham is representing Kelowna and says she jumped at the opportunity to continue the growth she's experienced from pageants so far.
I realized that because I participated in the Miss Kelowna Lady of the Lake program, I had grown so much, and I saw this kind of as an opportunity just to grow even more. And I sort of thought to myself, you know, why should I settle for something less than this? So I thought maybe I would just go for it and see what happens.
Okanagan Lake, the River Channel, and Skawhaw Lake, because Penticton is surrounded by lakes.
Camelia Vokey from Penticton says she and the other girls have been working hard in preparation for the pageant since the spring, all of them eager to continue that hard work.
The candidacy started in March, and so I was very involved in my community, volunteering at various events and hosting fundraisers to raise money for scholarships for this program. It was a lot of fun, and the crowned BC ambassadors will travel throughout the province promoting motivation, education, and self-esteem to other youth.
And here's another view.
Carly Henniger from Trail says many of the girls are driven by the desire to be a role model for others back home.
This is a brief description.
And I really wanted to be a motivation and an inspiration to the other girls in my community that I know want to do Miss Trail or want to do this program.
She adds that true friendships have come from getting to know the other candidates.
Last night we watched a movie and drank coffee together, and just like in our spare time, we just always want to be together. Like, we're all congregating over there just hanging out, and yesterday we were playing games and just getting to know each other, and we laughed so hard that we cried.
Tristan Westman from New Westminster says giving back to her community is a big part of why she chose to get involved.
It's just a really great opportunity to represent my city on a provincial level and tell everybody about the wonderful things in the community that there are to do. It's just a really great way to get yourself out into the community and to let people know about what you're doing and to just give back.
Merritt local Shayla Meerholder says she's happy to represent the host city, adding that the program has helped her develop her confidence.
I'm actually able to speak in front of a crowd now, which I was never able to do before. And it's definitely helped me make a lot of friends. And it's kind of neat to, you know, walk around the streets and let people see who we are and let them know, hey, I'm from Merritt.
What the giant's head was, they thought it could have been a lion's head.
Regardless of whether she receives a crown or not, Jacqueline Belanger from Summerland says the entire experience has been worth it.
No matter what the outcome, I just had to be a part of it one more time to represent my community, not only in my community, but on the provincial level. Through the As Your Candidacy, you learn that no matter what, you'll achieve anything. Like, it doesn't matter what the outcome is. It's a great experience.
The first ever candidate from Castlegar, Mariah Morris, says it means a lot to represent her city for the first time.
It means so much. It's been hard, and I've had a very good candidacy, and I've worked very hard. And I'm so proud to represent Castlegar and bring it to a new level, because I'm so proud of my community, and I want to share it with everybody.
Representing the tournament capital, Kamloops, Acacia Schmeaton-Canope says being an ambassador is about more than just being a good public speaker. It's about taking action.
You have to be a volunteer, and you have to
really have confidence in your community and in your province, and you have to be willing to give back to those communities. It's great to have really excellent public speaking skills and great to be knowledgeable, but you have to have that sense of community and that passion for volunteerism.
Representing the North Thompson Valley, Alexandra Brown says the potential for exploring your province and sharing that with your home community would be priceless.
Being an ambassador for British Columbia and being an ambassador for your community, and you get the opportunity at a much broader level to get to share that with everybody around BC. So you get to share your community around BC and you get to share BC around your community.
This is a hat.
And rounding out the candidates is Elizabeth Phillips, representing Lytton. She says the program is an opportunity to create relationships among the different communities.
A lot of communication skills, public speaking skills, and just to forge links of friendship within the whole province. My board is actually mostly cultural, so it feels good to represent where I'm from and what I am.
And this is what these 12 girls will all be vying for this weekend. One of three crowns worn by the current BC ambassadors, cared for so diligently, ready to rest atop three new heads.
It's such a great opportunity, and they've worked so hard these past few months, so I'm really very excited for them and to see how much hard work they've put in and the outcome.
Representing Kamloops provincially was an amazing experience. I love my hometown, and it was such an honor to be able to represent them all over the province of British Columbia.
I think it will be a lasting friendship for me throughout my life because both Paris and Sarah have been very supportive for me throughout the year and being very understanding and considerate.
On Friday, they have two showings. One is at 1 o'clock, and that is the personal speeches, and that will be for $10. And then in the evening at 6 o'clock, there is the community speeches and the talent, and that's for $20. And then the next day at 6 o'clock, there is the formal wear impromptu question and the coronation, and that is for $25. And of course, like, all the tickets are at the front door and everyone is welcome.
For more information, check out bcambassador.com. I'm Sam Numpson in Merritt for Shaw TV.